Bhagavan, the Supreme Absolute Truth, Vishnu, all-pervading personality of Godhead. So, His potency must be also spiritual. Just like the sun glow is reservoir of heat and light. Everyone we know. So his potency, the sun glow's potency, sunshine, is also heat and light. It is not different from the sun. Shakti means potency. Shakti, shakti mato abhida. The potency of a certain person is non-different. There is no difference in quality. The same example. The sun and the sunshine. Sunshine is the potency of the sun, but the quality of the sun and the quality of the sunshine is the same. Heat and light. So Vishnu Shakti, there are, according to the Vedic information, he has got many multifarious potencies. Parasya Shakti Vivida Ivasriyate. Different types of Shakti. We can see different types of agency, what is called energy, is working within this creation. Take for example the leaves of the tree. Some of them are green, some of them are red, some of them are yellow, some of them are mixed. Similarly, fruits, different taste, flowers, different flavor, varieties. But where from it is coming? The sunshine. The sunshine is the same, but it is acting in different way. So we see different manifestation. This is crude material example. Similarly, if we take the spiritual, original, then the original is Krishna. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Aham sarvasya prabhava. It is not different from Krishna. Aham sarvasya. All these colored manifestations, it is coming from Krishna. Matta sarvam pravartate. Everything is coming from me. With this understanding, he is real Krishna consciousness. finally understand that there is one only, ekam brahma ditya nasti, and Krishna is above brahma. We have got a slight idea of brahma, generally, but Krishna is para-brahma. There are many millions of brahmas, and above that, the supreme brahma is Krishna. Param-brahma, param-dhāma, pavitram, paramam-bhavā, Arjuna admits. So Krishna Shakti, everything is Krishna Shakti, potency. There is no doubt about it. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam prabhattati iti matya vāsudeva sarvamiti. Vāsudeva is everything. That is Krishna. But he is working in so many ways. How it is working, that is stated in the Vedas. Sābhāviti jñāna balakriyāsa. He has got so unlimited potency that things are being done as if naturally, without any endeavor. But the background is Krishna. Just like we see one flower, right? Very small flower. The stem is very fine. And the flower is decorated even in their different colors. But it is not an ordinary thing. If you are a painter, if you paint such a flower, it will take so many days. But it is coming. But don't think simply that it has come automatically. No, there is no such thing as automatically. The same as you, when you paint a flower, you have to employ so much energy. But Krishna has also do that, the same energy. But it is because it is so natural for Krishna, sāvāviti, jñāna balakriyā, so simply by his willing, it is happening. So he hasn't got to endeavor for it. That is the difference between Krishna's activities and our activities. Although we have got the tendency at least, because we are part and parcel of Krishna, we have got the same quality. Kṛtavya kya tathā parā. Kṛtavya means living entities. They are also of the same potency. So, then what is the difference? The difference is that the Kṣetrajña, the living entities, are prone to become under illusion. That is the difference. We are small, very small. Therefore, we are prone to be extinguished. Just like the fire, and the fire is spark. The spark, when it is out of the fire, it is extinguished. No more fire required. But so long it is playing with the fire, you will find the nice, brilliant sparks coming, now dancing. The quality is the same. Fire can burn, and the small spark, it falls down. It will burn, your clothes is very small, but it will itself become hot. This is avidya. The same spark, when he is out of Krishna's touch, it is extinguished. Avidya. Immediately he is covered by darkness, extinguished, his spiritual quality. Not finished, at least stopped for the time. His spiritual quality cannot be finished because it is spiritual. Nahannate hannamane sarire. The spiritual quality cannot be finished. It goes on. And on account of avidya, ignorance, it goes through another body, transmigration of the soul. And unless he is again revived to his original consciousness, he has to go through that. He has to struggle for existence. He is trying to get his original position, like Krishna's brilliant position, like the fire. So this is called struggle for existence. Avidya karma sangharta. They are trying to be happy. He'll find in New York City, they're simply struggling. What is the aim? The aim is how to become happy. Somebody is drinking, somebody is gambling, somebody is going to the restaurant, somebody is going to the Times Square, and somebody is going here, there. The real aim is how to become happy. But because in avidya, ignorance, they are unable to become happy. That is the position. Avidya, karma, sangha, anya, tithyasa. This avidya is illusion. Illusion. Just like we are now enwrapped, covered with this body, and I am thinking I am this body. This is avidya. I am not this body. So again he has to brought to this knowledge that you are not this body. Because he wanted to dominate over the material nature, therefore he has got this material body. Because he wanted to eat stew, he has got this hog's body. Because he wanted this, jump over unnecessarily, creating trouble, he has become monkey. Because he wanted to drink fresh blood, he has got the body of a tiger. This is called avidya. He is not neither tiger, nor pig, nor monkey, nor this so-called human being, nor American, nor Indian. He is spirit soul. That knowledge one has to come from that avidya, from ignorance. One has to come to the knowledge, then his life will be successful. So our Krishna consciousness movement is trying to bring back the human society, because it is not possible to bring back the monkeys and cats and dogs to Krishna consciousness. That is not possible. So those who are of the dog's mentality, cat's mentality, monkey mentality, it is difficult for them. They have to change their mentality by satsanga. This is called satsanga. Just like we are hearing from the Shastra and we are speaking from the Shastra, this is called satsanga. Satanga prasangat mama bija sangvida. Bhavanti ritkarna rasayana katha. By satsanga, by real spiritual association, by talking with them, by mixing with them, satanga prasanga, mama bija sangvida, then we can learn about the unlimited potencies of Krishna. Mama bija sangvida, bhavanti ritkarna rasayana katha. Then it becomes very pleasing to the heart and to the ear by satang prasanga. Otherwise it is not possible. If you go to a professional reciter, it will enter in this ear and go away this ear, that's all. Because there is no life, it is business. So you cannot do business with Krishna. Krishna is not agreeable to this proposal. He is master. You cannot utilize him for your service. You must engage yourself to his service. That is wanted. Sarva dharmān purittajya māmīkaṁ saranam. That if he be in that attitude that Krishna is my master, I must serve Krishna. I shall not take Krishna an instrument to become my servant. That is not possible. Although it is said that Chaturvidha Bhajanti Ma, Sukriti Na Arjuna, four kinds of man, Sukriti Na, whose background is pious, they come to Krishna. One who is impious, he cannot come. Namāga duṣkitinam mūrhā prabhadyam dhīnarādhava māyā purhitajñāna āsuri bhāva. Why a few selected person come here? Because it requires background of pious activities. Otherwise it is not possible. We do not expect that 10% of people will become Krishna conscious. That is not possible. But if there is one ideal Krishna conscious person, he can do benefit to many thousands. If there is one moon in the sky, he can illuminate the whole universe. Natatara sahasas, not these tinkling stars, it is not possible. So, people are suffering avidya karma sangha anya, being enwrapped by avidya, illusion. They are struggling for existence. So, Krishna personally comes himself to deliver them. Paritranaya sadhunam vinasaya chaduskita. That is his two businesses. So, the Krishna conscious, Krishna's devotee also take up the business of Krishna by this Krishna consciousness movement, and it will do good to him and as well as to the persons amongst whom he will preach. But preach, don't manufacture preaching. Preach as it is in the śāstra. That is Chaitanya Mahāprabhu's in his life. Jare dākho tare kaho Krishna upadesha. You do not become a rascal guru yourself by manufacturing some imagination. You do this, give me some money, and you become God, you become this, you become. These rascals don't do. One thing do. What is that? What is said by Krishna? You say. What is the difficulty? What Krishna has said, you say. Manmana bhavamad bhakta madhyaji magnamaskru. These four things, that you just become a devotee of Krishna. How can I become devotee? You come to the temple, offer little obeisances, take prasadam. So what is the difficulty? If you say there is no difficulty, and if one comes, there is no difficulty. But they are so rascals, they will not come. You are giving so much facilities that come here, live in this nice building, and hear about Krishna, take prasadam, chant and dance, very happy life. But they will become hawks. They are preparing their life for that purpose. They become a dog next life. They prepare like that. So therefore, the Krishna consciousness movement is the topmost welfare activities in the world. People should try to understand it and join it and take advantage of it. Thank you very much.